promised, as the promise was extracted from me, I was going to play this song and talk about it a little bit, because the song continues to be recorded beautifully. And the first recording of it was, of course, Linda Ronstadt's, the greatest voice of my generation, I think. And everybody wanted to sing it like Linda, and then try as they might. And there were a lot of really good records of it. Glenn Campbell made a record, it was a big hit in the 80s, 85, I think. Was nominated for a Grammy for Best Song, and was nominated against my friend Steve Goodman for City of New Orleans. And poor Stevie, you know, he had the winning hand as far as the Grammys were concerned. He died during the year, so of course we all voted for him. And he won. And I remember saying to Brian afterwards, "Well, that was pretty smart, wasn't it?" Song, and she said, "What is that?" I said, "I have no idea. I'm just sort of stuck on this bridge. I don't know. You know, it changes chords like that and goes back to the original key without some kind of bridge in between." She said, "Well, I don't know, but I think it's really beautiful, and I'd like to record it if you ever finish it." And paddled off back to bed. And I said, "Really?" I had it finished by morning. Done. "Hey, honey. Remember?" "Oh, yeah." And she went right in and recorded it. Beautiful record of it. And then everybody else recorded it. It's wonderful. Everybody's recording is simple except mine. Mine got really complicated. So I had the orchestra at my command. And I kind of like it, like bare bones like this. So this is what she would have heard if I was playing for her. "Faithless love, like a river flows, like raindrops falling on a broken rose, down in some valley where nobody goes, where the night blows in like a cold dark wind. Faithless love." I'm standing telling somebody where nobody goes. His best love was found, throwing his chili on.